Hey guys, it's Brian from guideattacking.com and welcome to the last part of the shellcode execution tutorial. In this part I'm going to cover a DLL injection or shellcode execution using QUser APC. And to start off, let me quickly explain what an APC actually is. So an APC stands for Asynchronous Procedure Call. And usually Windows uses this to assign certain functions which have to be executed to threads which go to sleep, for example, or into another wait state. So usually when you call sleep in your code, your thread will just go to sleep. And actually in this case, it's not alertable. But for example, if you call sleep X and set alertable to true, then instead of going to sleep, it'll first start in case there are procedures queued, it'll start off to execute these APCs and then it'll go into sleep or maybe just resume execution. And what we are going to do is we are going to inject shellcode into the target process and then use QUser APC to queue this shellcode as an APC to all of the threads of the target process. And in case one of these threads goes into a waiting state, it'll start to execute the APCs in its queue and also run our shellcode, and our DLL is injected, or whatever you're trying to accomplish with the shellcode. So let's start off by, as always, allocating some memory in the target process. pcodecave equals virtual alloc ex pass h target process null pointer for the address about 100 bytes in size, mem commit mem reserve. We've done this thousands of times now, and set it to page execute read write as always. In case that fails, pcodecave set last win32 error to get last error and return srqapc error can't alloc mem. After that, we are already start generating our shellcode, so ifdev underscore win64 else and if, and let me quickly copy paste the shellcode. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention this, all of the shellcode is of course linked in the description of the video, because no one can be asked to just type all of this shit out, to be honest. Well, I had to, but yeah. So let me quickly explain the shellcode again. Just like last time, we got three buffers, one for the returned value, one for the argument and one for the routine. And we just start off by our jump instruction, which will jump to the next instruction of the shellcode. And here we are just going to... So first I should mention that the APC will receive an argument which is stored in RCX, and this argument will be the pointer to the shellcode, actually to the begin of the code cave. And so we can just use this argument RCX to access our variables. So we don't have to do any hot patching at all. That's a good thing. So the first thing I'm doing here is I'm moving proutine into rex, because I want to call rex afterwards. And I'm also moving the argument parc into RCX. Then I'm setting up the stack. I'm calling the function and then I'm updating the stack. So here I'm actually subtracting 28 bytes instead of 20 for some internal technical reasons of Windows, because the way these functions are called, we have to use 28 and not 20, because the stack has to be 10 bytes aligned. But whatever, just use 28 instead of 20 here. After that's done, we are checking whether the function call succeeded. So the function you call should not return zero. Anything else but zero is fine. So test rex. And in case that's zero, jump if... So it's kind of confusing. Test rex. And a jump if equal instruction is basically test if rex is zero and then jump. And so in case it's zero, we're going to jump to 2a, which is just the return instruction. And in case it succeeded, we are going to grab the address of the code cave again and store the returned value. And we are updating the jump instruction, which is right at the beginning of the code cave, to jump to the return instruction directly. So this is due to, because again, we are going to queue this to all of the threads. So we have a couple of tries. In case the first thread fails for some reason, we can still wait for the second thread to execute it. So that's why we just test whether the function succeeded or not, and depending on that, patch the jump or not. So the code offset, as you can see already, will be, I'll just call it code offset as all, it will be 0x18. And let me quickly set up the buffers at the top, reinterpret cast, void, double void of course, shellcode plus 8, and set that equal to parc, and reinterpret cast, void, shellcode plus 0x10, and set that equal to proutine. And that's already it for the x64 shellcode generation. So let me quickly copy the x68 shellcode. It is at switch to x68. Basically, the apps, it's exactly the same. The same buffers, we just use the x68 stack frame creation here. The same jump instruction, which first jumps to the next instruction, and in case at the end I'm updating the jump to jump down to the pop EBP and return instruction. Just the call, the same test EX, and the same jump of equal, etc. It's exactly the same, just the x68 opcodes instead of the x64. So in this case, the code offset, as you can see, will be at 0xc bytes. So code offset, or 12 bytes, decimal 0xc. And let's update the buffers again, double void. I'm well aware that this isn't a real double void pointer, it's just a void pointer, just a pointer to an array of void pointers, but I'll just call it double void because it's easier. Set this to parc again, and last but not least, double void again, shellcode plus 0x8 is equal to proutine. So that's it for our shellcode generation, and now we can write the shellcode into memory. Let's create a bool, read, and set it equal to write process memory, h target proc, p code cave, shellcode, size of shellcode, and a null pointer. In case bread is 0, so if not bread, set the last win32 error to get last error. In case don't forget to free the memory, so virtual free x, h target proc, decode cave, 0, memory release, and return SR QAPC error, write process memory fail. After that we are going to create a handle snapshot, h snap, and we are going to create a snapshot of all the threads in the target process. TH32CS underscore snap thread, and pass get process ID H target process. In case H snap is an invalid handle value, make sure to check for invalid handle value here and not if the handle is 0, because create2lab32 snapshot actually returns invalid handle value, not 0, unlike open process, for example. And the cleanup will basically be the same, so let me quickly just copy this and paste it, and just update the error code, and this will be th32 underscore fail. After that's done, we are going to just create a copy of the process ID. I'll just call it dword target PID, get process ID, H target proc, and boolean apc queued, and by default this is false. And last but not least, we're going to create a papc func, which is just a pointer to an apc function, and this will be reinterpret cast papc func, reinterpret cast byte pointer p code cave plus code offset. Then we are going to create a thread entry structure. I'll just call it TE32, initialize it with zeros, and make sure to set the DW size member to the size of TE32. just like with all the module entries and process entries, the same thing. Then bret equals thread 32 first. We are now going to enumerate all the snaps, all the threads using the snapshot, and pass address of the TE32 instance. Then, if not bret, and let me quickly copy paste all of this. And yeah, get last error, and don't forget to actually close the snapshot handle here. So close handle h snap. And oh yeah, and update the error code to T32 first fail. I think yeah, 32 first fail. After that, we're going to create a do while loop. So do while bret, and if TE32 dot T32 owner process ID is equal to target PID. So it's kind of a weird functionality, to be honest, because we are already passing the process ID to create toolet32 snapshot, but for some reason this still enumerates all the threads on the system. I don't know why. It says so in the documentation, so we still have to check for the process ID again here. Then we are going to try to open a handle to the process. So handle h thread to the thread, not to the process. So we are using open thread, and we only need the thread set context. Set context access desired access right. Set this to false and pass t32.th32 thread ID. So I messed this up kinda. Sorry about that. So and if h thread. So if open thread succeeded, we are going to continue, otherwise this won't really make sense. If q user apc and pass p shellcode h thread and reinterpret cast ulong pointer, yeah, of course, ulong pointer and pcode cave. So, oh, no semicolon here. So, as I said, we are going to pass pcode cave as an argument to the APC function so that we can just use the argument as a pointer to our code cave. So, in case that succeeds, we are going to close the handle to the thread, close handle h thread, and set APC queued to true. In case that fails, we are going to set our last win32 error to get last error, but we won't just return here, not because there might be a chance that we grab a bunch of other threads. Actually, let's move the close handle h thread outside of this if statement, because it doesn't matter whether QUserAPC succeeded or not, we are going to close the thread handle anyway. So that's almost it. So don't forget bret equals thread 32 next, of course. We want to go for the next thread afterwards and pass the address of TE32. So that should be it for our loop. Now we can close the handle of the snapshot, this time for good. And in case no APC was queued, we're going to free, copy it because I'm lazy, we're going to free the code cave and return SRQAPC error no APC thread. And so like this. And oh yeah, and set an else statement here. We're going to update the last win32 error to 0 just to be sure. So in case one, what's this bogus here? I forgot an else statement here, sorry. So in case QUserAPC failed and last error got set, we can still grab the old error code here. But in case it failed once but worked for other threads, we just want to set the error code back to 0 again, because it doesn't really make sense today. Now we are going to create a timer. Dword timer equals get tick count as always. And we're going to set the out variable to 0, which is an argument of the function here. and create a do while loop while not remote red, while not out, sorry. And do reprocess memory h target process p code cave and out size of out and a null pointer. So again, here I'm checking whether out is zero or not, and that's why your function you're going to call should not return zero, just like because of the test exex or test rex thingy. And if get tick count minus timer is bigger than SR remote timeout, which is 5 seconds, we are just going to return SR as WX error timeout. And we are going to sleep for 10 milliseconds. After that's done, we will simply, oh, I forgot the semicolon after the while, sorry. And we're just going to do reprocess memory one last time to read the actual returned value. Actually, this doesn't even make sense because we just did it up here, so screw that. So like this, and we can now return SR error success. Just like this. So we can't actually virtual 3x all of the stuff at this point, because even if our shellcode got executed by a bunch of threads, it might still be queued to another thread. And there's no way like to something like unqueue user APC or something. This function simply doesn't exist. It's really, really complicated to unqueue an APC, so we just don't care about it. So we just leave the shellcode in the target process. Okay, let's test it. Let me quickly change this back to test console minus x68.exe and test console x64. And also in the main update this to lmqUserAPC, like this. I'm going to start off. Yeah, the dummy thread is running perfect, and let's inject the DLL and see if it works. And perfect, as you can see, the shitcode gets executed. And let's do the same for the x64. And drumroll. And it works perfectly fine. So that's basically it for this tutorial. The tutorial thread on guideattacking.com will be linked in the video description as well. And in case you run into problems, please comment on guideattacking.com and not in the YouTube comment section. That's it. I'm Royan. Visit guideattacking.com, subscribe to PewDiePie, and see ya. Bye.